On the way back from Imberbus this year, I had booked assistance on this train from Bristol to Leeds, set to arrive in Leeds at 10:37 p.m. As a wheelchair user, the only way I can get on or off a train is if staff help with a wheelchair ramp, so it's always an anxious wait to see if one turns up.
Get a platform staff to come and get you, alright?
Thank you.
The driver was excellent, thank goodness he spotted me. Amazing. That's the emergency door release. It prevents the doors closing and the train leaving with me on it. Note, however, that it is out of most wheelchair users' reach.
Really sorry about this. I'm just a driver, so I can't actually put a ramp down and get you off. Whereabouts did you get on?
Bristol, and I've got assistance booked.
Okay, yeah. Be sure to write in about this because not acceptable, obviously, leaving you on. There's no platform staff here at the moment. As soon as one arrives, we'll get you off straight away. Again, please write in because you shouldn't be left on. It's not fair, but we will be along. All right. Cheers.
Thank you. Lovely.
So did you say something?
No, I was just laughing to myself. Yeah, I love being left on the train at bloody 6 minutes to 11 when my last bus is in 11 minutes now.
Hello, it's Isaac Driver again here. I've managed to get a couple of platforms out. They're just going to sort something for you, alright?
Thank you for that, appreciate it. Thank you, appreciate it.
Yeah, no worries, sir. Sorry once again, we will get you off as soon as possible.
It's not your problem, it's not your fault, and solidarity.
Being stuck on that deserted platform in the dark was terrifying for me as a burly white male. It must be much more terrifying for women, older people, and black and minority ethnic people.
This is no longer funny. I'm starting to panic a bit.
Driver again, I've just done contact with my control now, because this is getting a
I'm sorry, I know it's not your responsibility. I'm really starting to panic.
Yeah, no worries. Don't be sorry. This isn't your fault at all. Something's gone wrong on our end. You should have been tucking off on time. Don't worry. The train's not going to move without you up there, and we will be with you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Ramp's here now.
Thank you. Thanks for sorting.
Many apologies.
Okay. I've just missed my last bus home.
Can't be helped. I'll just see what's happening.
Cheers. Head assistance booked.
Slow.
I know, I'm going slow. Thank you.
Right, don't worry. Thank you for waiting.
This is nice.
Sorry,
you had
to wait that long, yeah.
Let's see what's happening here. Come with us then.
I was with this lady, had to walk her out the station, really disabled. And then yours, it doesn't say that you're on board. It says it's pending. So I was well late, I was about 45 when I got back from the taxi. So I sort of assumed that it's pending. So where are we going now then?
I'm going to Weatherby, but my last bus went 5 minutes ago. The next bus is tomorrow morning.
That's very good. We'll have to see what we can do.
I was supposed to be on that 11:05 X99.
So nobody can take you off?
Nobody did a walkthrough. The driver eventually noticed me.
Wow.
And he did his best, it's but it's not his job. He was great, but it, you know.
So this gentleman, obviously he was left on the train.
Yeah.
Got my last bus. My last
was that 5 past 11?
We went at 5 past 11 from the station.
What, from the bus station?
No, from Leeds station, stop D at Boar Lane. I was supposed to catch it at 5 past 11. But obviously I was stuck on there for a good like half an hour until now since it got in. So I missed it.
Where are you going to ride it then?
Yeah.
What's your name, please?
Doug Pawley.
First name of
the Pawley, P-A-U-L-L-E-Y.
L-L-E-Y.
Yeah. See, I've got a booked assistance to get off the train at 10:37.
Oh, it didn't come in until 45, did it?
It came in 8 minutes late at 10:45.
It came in at what time?
10:45.
Yeah.
So I still had 20 minutes.
Yeah.
But then I was still on there when the bus went.
Right, okay.
You got your telephone? I'm so sorry.
I have, but I don't do phone calls because I'm deaf.
Yeah. See that building there?
Oh, yeah.
Just round the corner from there. Behind the steps.
Because I struggle with autism and hearing loss, I don't do phone calls.
Right. They won't call them, they'll actually text you.
They will phone me. I've been here. Is this CMAC?
Yeah. But
they always phone me. I'm not giving my phone number out.
Right.
We'll get back to it.
Thank you.
Sorry,
Do you have your horse dog? He'll take you around in a minute.
Thank you.
I'm just waiting for confirmation that he's going to come to my telephone.
Yeah, thank you.
I'll take you to your home address anyway, but I think I'm hoping they've requested him with a big...
CMAC.
Yeah.
They're appalling with their wheelchair access. They are the hits about wheelchair accessible taxis. So I'll believe it when I see it, but thank you for doing it anyway.
I've told them that it's electric wheelchairs. So
yeah.
They should send a big one of the big ones out.
They should do.
Sorry about all this.
Have you ever had an accessible taxi through CMAC before? They're utterly, terribly unreliable. They're utterly clueless.
Yes.
And they charge 3 times as much for an accessible taxi as for a standard one.
Right.
There'll be a whole load of accessible taxis at the taxi rank and they won't contract with any of them and then we'll wait hours. No, CMAC are appalling.
Yes.
Railway stuffed up with me this evening, but involving CMAC is only ever going to make things worse.
Yes.
But then Northern won't change the contract, you know? So you end up with CMAC.
Right.
They're fine for non-disabled people.
Yes.
Utterly useless.
Yes, yes.
That's Peugeot E7. I reckon I could get in that. But it's sat there. They can't use it because it's not CMAC.
Yeah.
And some minutes later, the accessible taxi from the taxi rank left with somebody else in it, leaving me to wait further. Meanwhile, it was well past 11:30 at night.
My wife knows what's happening?
Oh, please, are you due to go home?
Don't, never mind. I'm staying here.
Are you sure?
I'm 1000% positive.
This isn't fair on you if
don't
you finish
worry,
your
don't
shift.
Worry about it. Don't worry.
Another 10 minutes waiting and we're approaching an hour since my train arrived in the station. My bus would be arriving in Wetherby now, but as it is, I'm still waiting for my CMAC taxi at Leeds.
I think there's no point in you waiting outside here. It's too cold. I think we're waiting here when we get that message.
Okay.
Finally, at a minute to midnight, CMAC confirmed that they have dispatched a taxi for me.
Last 3 letters, K-E-J, so I'm trying to find it.
And 5 minutes later, it actually turned up.
You got it?
Yeah.
Oh, you star! That was comparatively speedy for them. 50 minutes. Thank you so much.
Yeah. No.
I appreciate it.
I was finally on the way home. The back of my head was pressed against the low roof of the taxi and I didn't have a seatbelt fitted or offered, but I suppose beggars can't be choosers. CMAC openly charged me £27 for a standard taxi to my nearest station and £67 for a wheelchair accessible one, yet despite charging over twice as much they still send inaccessible taxis, if they send any at all. They do this all the time. Mind you, they wouldn't be needed if the railway met their duty to assist disabled people. Do better, CrossCountry and Northern.